Assalamualaikum, hi there friends. I'm back with another cryptocurrency silent miner tutorial, and in this video I'll be sharing Bytecoin mining silent miner for Minergate. I previously shared Monero silent miner. Now this time I'm sharing Bytecoin silent miner, which can be used for Bytecoin mining. This silent miner is much more faster and better than the previous one. It's FUD and Hidden miner, which once started will mine Bytecoin for you, and it will be collected in your Minergate profile. Secondly, good thing about the miner is that it is resistant. Like if you restart your PC, the miner will also automatically start in the background silently. If you have PC or laptop other than your own use PC and want to earn some money using that PC or even on your current PC, so the best way, of course, most of the user are using it as a miner, so it can mine cryptocurrency. The same case is here. If you want to set up your own Bytecoin mining silent miner, it's like silent miner for Minergate, so you don't need to start it every single time, but just for once run it, and it will run forever until you stop it. That's all what I'll be sharing in this tutorial, so stay tuned and let's get started. First thing first, you will need Minergate account. Minergate is like a miner supported cloud mining service which helps you to mine any cryptocurrency, and you don't need that extra pool setup and all those technical stuff, but just you make an account and download their miner. It starts mining using your PC, but that's not good if you want to mine silently or on another extra PC you have but don't want to run the miner every single time. So for that I'll be sharing my miner, which is safe, fast and much more better. I made it with some VBS and bash scripts. Other than that, I used XFast CLI miner, which is much more faster than other miners out there. You can check all my files and even replace it with latest miner if Minergate release new version of XFast miner by the time you are watching the video. But for right now it's working and undetected, so antivirus won't create problems if you want to run it on your PC. So that was about the Bytecoin silent miner and Minergate. Now let's set up the silent miner. By the way, if you don't have a Minergate account, I'll leave my referral link in the description. Make your account using my referral link. Once you got your Minergate account, the next thing is the miner. This miner, you have to download it. The link will be in description. Once you got the miner, just extract it using winner. Make sure you get winner, as we will need this further for one point actually. After extraction, you'll get these files. Here just you need to edit this start file, and then we'll update this file in the silent miner. We have to edit this file and we will update this into this silent miner. For editing, just right click on it and click edit. Here in this file you need to replace the username actually, this one, with yours. You can use your email which you use for Minergate login info, or even you can use the username which can be found in the profile section of Minergate. This is actually my username, so I'm using username. Once you replace the username, just save the file. Now we need to update this file into the Bytecoin silent miner. For that, right click on the Bytecoin silent miner file and select the option which says open with WinRAR, this one. Now here just drag this start file into the miner, just like that, and click OK. There you go. Okay, one more thing, you will also find this Tigerzplace percent file in the folder, which is my percentage. If you are willing to include my percentage, so I'll also get some earning from your miner. So just extract the files and drag and drop it to the Bytecoin silent miner. And if you just want to make your own miner, no percent, no share, no nothing at all, just all yours, then just delete the file and you're good to go. Only need to bring this file into the, and if you want to include my shares, kind of like a percentage, so just extract it here and drag these files into the miner, just like this. But I'll delete this for right now. This is just for you if you want to include my shares, so you will have to do the same thing. Okay, one more thing, I forgot. You will notice this one, this is actually about the threads. You can increase this by 2, 3 or more like that, but strongly recommend you to use one or two, not more than two. I used one. If you want to increase it, so you can increase it for your purpose. But for me, I am actually recording, and later on I will be checking this miner. So I reduced the threads, so I won't get some error like not responding. Previously I got my app crashed, so that's why I'm actually using one thread for right now. So we are done. That's all you need to edit, and your Bytecoin mining silent miner is now fully ready. As I said, it will be persistent, so as I run the silent miner after my PC restarts, it will start Bytecoin mining again in the background. So I don't need to restart it again and again. I just need to run it once and it will run forever. It basically makes a startup keys. Before running the silent miner, let me open and check the miner current state in Minergate. After that we can check it. Okay. Also let me check the defender. Okay. It's up to date. Let me check. There are new updates, man. We can also monitor the detection ratio in runtime. Let's see. So currently we don't have any workers online for Bytecoin Neuro, nothing. So let's check the miner. Double clicking the Bytecoin silent miner. It will not make any pop-up or some sort of notifier, but it's executed and it will be running in the background right now. To check it, just open task manager, then in detail search for CMD, which is console. CMD, there we go. As you can see, it's running and it wasn't detected by Defender, as you can see here. So don't check it online with antivirus tools. Just be careful with that. Never ever check such tools online, otherwise it won't be undetected anymore. So it's kind of request, don't check it online. Now let's check the Minergate status. Okay, refresh it. There we go, one currency is now up. There we go, Bytecoin. Hash rate is not yet updated. Keep in mind that it will take some time to update the worker and hash rate status in your Minergate. I've shown this many times in my videos. Still not updated. There we go, it's up and running. My hash rate is 16 point something hashes per second. It's because one thread, the other reason it's recording. As you can see, it's now 100%. And the third reason is my laptop is not that good, so that's why. Okay, now for closing, if you want to close the miner, just close this CMD terminal, CMD console, whatever you call it. Now just end the task and it will close it. And if we refresh it, it's still up. I'm not sure, but we will close the process. Actually process is update.exe, this one. This is actually the process name. If you get the same error, like if you close the CMD and still it's running, so you can close the process. And boom, there we go, it's closed now. Other than that, if you completely want to stop the miner so it doesn't start the next time when you start your PC, so for that you will need to disable the startup key. So for that, just head over to startup and disable this key, which is updates. Okay, so that's it. But before logging out, I would like to include the testing method as well, because some user might get errors. So I'll show you how you can check your miner. Like, it was smooth this time, and it's because I didn't get any error. For those who get error, will not see any process, and that's why they get confused. So how to know that? That is something I'll be showing you now. All you need is to extract the miner file, this file actually. Extract it here, and we'll then check the logs using the start batch file, where we can see the status by status of Bytecoin mining. But make sure you open CMD in that folder, like in the same folder, and then we will run the start file. Don't run it directly, because it will, if you get error, it will disappear at once, so you won't get log at all. Press Control and Shift and then right click, and probably you will get open in CMD here, some kind of like this option. I'm not getting it, but maybe you can get it in the update version of operating system. For me, I will run the CMD and then change the directory. So I'll copy this folder here and rename it as test, because it's long name, so I don't wanna type it in everything. So it's on desktop, so I will change it to desktop and then test as test. Now here we need to type start.batch. okay, so there we go. It's actually the same file as this one, but as I said, if you open it directly and if there's some error, you will not get the pop-up actually. And here, if it's now working right, but if in case you get some error which can be seen in the console log, then you can search for it online, and after fixing you can use the miner. Okay, hope this will help you more. Well, that's all for you guys. Hope you guys will find it helpful. If you find this miner not working anymore in the future, make sure you let me know in the comment section or on my page, so I'll update it for you guys. Also hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon if you like such videos, so every time I upload new videos you will be notified. So yeah, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in my next video with more tricks and tutorials. Allah Hafiz.